When we ended our file.io and API error handling section, we asked, what do you want to hear about next? And you said, state machines. So here we go. Now suppose we want to perform a couple of lab tests. A basic test, an advanced test, and then notify the user. How could we program this? Well, it could look like this, where we have four separate sub-VIs connected by the error clusters, and data being passed between sub-VIs. We can generalize these steps into states. By definition, a state is a unique configuration of information in a program. It generally performs a test or satisfies a condition. Now we could program this application sequentially, but then we would always need to go in the same order. But what if we wanted to change the order on the fly during runtime? Or stop the code at any time instead of waiting until the end? Or repeat the same step multiple times? Or execute some code only if a certain condition is met? Now these are difficult or impossible to do with sequential programming, but all really easy with state programming. We start state programming with a state transition diagram, or state diagram. It represents states and transitions between them. By definition, a transition is a condition that is satisfied when moving between states. Let's take a look here at that lab test application. We start here, and we go to the initialized state, and then moving on to the idle state. In the idle state, we're waiting on the user to do something. The user has two options. Either click on basic test or stop. If basic test is clicked, we go and perform basic test. If that test passes, we go on to the advanced test. But if the test fails, we go to notify. If we go on to advanced test, then we'll always go to notify when we're finished. And then we always go back to idle. And the user can then either click on basic test again or click the stop button and stop the application. We always begin in this design phase, and then we go and implement in LabVIEW code with the state machine. So let's look at it. I'll hit the run button, and we see we've gone from initialized to idle. And if I click on basic test, we move to the basic test and then notify, because it looks like the basic test failed. Let's see how this is implemented on the block diagram. Here's the infrastructure of a state machine. We have a while loop with a case structure inside, a shift register with the output of the shift register going to the case selector terminal of the case structure, and then we also have this, which is an enum constant. So to begin with, we initialize the first state of the state machine. In this case, initialize. Initialize passes in here, and we choose the initialize state, where we are executing the code for initialize. When we're finished, the state machine tells us where we'll go next. In this case, idle. Idle will go out of this case to the right shift register, we iterate the loop, and the next iteration, it comes out of the left shift register. And that enum chooses the next state, which is idle. In idle, as we see, we're polling the basic test boolean and the stop boolean. Now in both cases, you see that we're also updating the status on the front panel so the user knows which state we're in, just with a string, idle or initialize. Now if the user in the idle state does not click on the basic test button, then we stay in the idle state. Idle goes out to the right shift register, iterate, comes out the left, we stay here, and check again. We're also pulling that stop button to see if it's been pressed. If, on the other hand, the user clicks on the basic test button, we go to basic test. Goes into the right shift register, comes out the left, and we call the basic test sub-VI. As we saw in our state transition diagram, in basic test, we're checking to see if the test has passed, pass or fail. So, coming from basic test will be data here indicating whether the test has passed or not. If the test passed, advanced test passes out of our select function and chooses the next state. If we fail, we go to notify, just like we see in our state transition diagram. Pass, go to advanced test. Fail, go to notify. Going to advanced test, we see we just performed that test and always go to notify. In the notify, we just call the notify sub-VI. and back to idle, where we wait on our user to tell us what to do next. That's our overview of state machines, and this particular lab test application addressed with a state machine. Next time, we're going to actually build the state machine to do this. And just a note, this state machine section is taken right out of our Lucid LabVIEW Fundamentals 1 course, right at the end, in application programming. To find out more about the course, go to sixclear.com/labviewtraining.